panel during the session. Thank you, President.
Dr. Junius HO will address the Council on the report of the panel on Information Technology and Broadcasting 2020-2021. Dr. Honorable Junius HO. Mr. President, as the Chairman of the Information Technology and Broadcasting Panel, I have the work report of the panel laid on the table of this Council, and I will highlight the main points. The panel was very concerned about the development of innovation and technology in Hong Kong. Members supported the administration's measures to develop a smart city and the promotion of e-government. Members urged the administration to further promote the one-stop personalized I'm Smart platform and to enhance its functions to tie in with our anti-epidemic efforts. In addition, members requested the administration to further open up its data and encourage businesses and social organizations to apply the government data effectively and thus be more facilitating in their service to the public. The administration also reported to the panel the application of technology to support infection control and prevention. Members urged the administration to answer our question as to when we can resume quarantine-free cross-boundary travel. We urged the administration to launch the Hong Kong Health Code as soon as possible, and we should share and recognize mutually the testing outcome as well as the health codes between the mainland, Macau and Hong Kong so as to facilitate resumption of quarantine-free travel. To ensure that Hong Kong is at the most advanced level in telecommunication services, the panel appointed that the administration should take up a more positive and proactive role in the development of the fifth generation telecommunications technology and service. To expand the scope of coverage, the authorities should provide more suitable sites and premises for the installation of 5G base stations and related facilities. Members supported the administration's proposal to auction more spectrum and introduction of more comprehensive safeguards to protect underground telecommunications facilities, as well as the setting up of a non-carrier licensing system to tie in with the development of the Internet of Things. Many members have criticized the RHK for having programs that were inaccurate and unbiased, with high production costs but poor outcome. Earlier this year, the administration released the review report on the governance and management of the RHK. Members had an in-depth discussion with the administration regarding the report and its recommendations, which together with the progress of the reform of the editorial mechanism were generally welcomed by the members. We held a special meeting. We are glad to see that with the new director of broadcasting, there have been a number of new measures to implement the recommendations of the review report. We welcome the recommendations in the report. We are also in recognition of the reform carried out to the editorial mechanism of the RHK. We would like to take this opportunity to thank members for the support of the work of the panel. Thank you.
Dr. Loai Kwok will address the Council on the report of the panel on development.